Hey, what's up, language learners? I hope you're doing fantastic. Today, I want to make a quick video about a great way to engage with content in your target language. It's a technique that you can make use of very early on in the process and with languages that don't have a ton of content. We call it the multi-pass method. And the essence is very simple. Use content multiple times, but in very different ways. There are lots of benefits to immersing in the same content multiple times. It makes it more comprehensible, and it lets your brain soak in more of the language that you probably didn't get the first time. And it lets you actually understand the content rather than just hoping that you understand it. Let's look at the different ways that you can engage with a single piece of content. Number one, sentence mining. Two, three channel reading. 3, intensive reading, 4, intensive listening, 5, condensed audio, and 6, free flow watching. You can mix and match any of those approaches to make the most of a single piece of content. Let me give you a quick rundown of each of the list items. Sentence mining is when you go through a piece of content and make flashcards for unknown words. And then after you're done, you review those cards over the coming days and weeks. It's a fantastic way to learn more vocabulary about something that you enjoy. I made a video about sentence mining with ASV Player that you can watch here. And then once you've mined an episode or movie, you have some Anki cards which make for great little interactions with the content. 3 channel reading is what we call it when there are 3 input channels entering your brain to help you understand something. For example, reading, listening, and seeing at the same time, which is what you do when you watch a TV show or a movie with subtitles. If you use a tool like ASV Player, Language Reactor, or another tool like that, you can have it auto pause after each line so that you have time to listen and read to the content. When I do 3 channel reading, I almost always sentence mine at the same time, so these can be combined into a single sitting. Intensive reading is another very useful activity for many reasons. My video from last week actually dives into it in a lot more depth. If you're interested in really trying it out, I recommend going and watching that video. But in a few words, intensive reading is when you go very slowly through a text and work to understand everything. It can take up to 5 or even 10 times as long to read something, but in my opinion, the results are worth it. You spend so much time with the language and its structure that things make more sense and feel easier when you're immersing at full speed. I like to read things by going word by word and save everything because it really helps me to build out a network of connected words. But it would be really effective to also just look up words here and there. How you approach all of these activities is going to depend on your level of understanding in your target language. Intensive listening is another useful activity you can do. There are a few different ways to do it, but the essence is listen carefully and check your work. One of the ways is basically the same as 3 channel reading, but you have the subtitles hidden. And whenever you don't hear something, you listen again, and then maybe a third time, and if you still finally can't hear what's happening, then you enable the subtitles and listen once more. This is very strong ear training, since it's easy to zone out and miss something, so doing it intensively makes you really focus and makes it a lot harder. This is a hard activity to get good at, because it takes a lot of practice, but when you do, it can improve your listening abilities a lot. Another fairly popular way to engage with content even more is through condensed audio, which is when you listen to it again, but just the audio, and you can remove all the parts that don't have dialogue so that you're just focused on the language. That's why it's called condensed. The trouble with condensed audio is that there isn't a super easy way to make it, and it's not even that useful. There's a tool called Condenser, but I couldn't get it to work. Migaku also has a pretty good condensed audio creation tool, but it literally just records the audio and skips between the subtitle lines, so you have to wait for it to do that in real time, maybe even overnight, and there's the possibility that something happens on your computer, ruining the audio file. So this can be hit and miss. And like I said, this is also the least useful of the activities on this list, and so skipping it is probably a good thing. But if it sounds interesting or helpful to you, I recommend looking into it further. And the final, easiest way to reuse media is by simply watching it again. That's it. Nothing else fancy, no lookups, no pausing, no annoying tools, just sit back and enjoy. A note though, you can do whatever you want with free flow. If you want to look up a word or two that you know, go ahead. The psychic damage of being frustrated isn't going to help you at all. I think this is most useful as the final way to go through a piece of content, since it allows you to reap the rewards of really studying that content and feeling like you've mastered it and learned a ton. There's also a secret 7th item on the list, which is having seen the content before and knowing what's happening. This often happens when you watch a dubbed movie from your childhood or something because you know the story. I personally am doing that right now with the Czech dub of Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. I watched it while doing sentence mining with unknown words and sentences, as well as three-channel reading, which took me about twice as long to watch the movie since it's not super complex and there's only about an hour of dialogue. Because dialogue-heavy things can take up to three times as long. Anyways, and now I'm reviewing the Anki cards that I made for the first pass, and have started reading through the subtitles as a book with loot. I'm about a sixth of the way through that, but it's really quite fun to remember the context and the scenes of every single line and look up all the words. And then once I'm done rereading the script, I'm going to watch the movie once or twice more, just with free flow, to soak it all in. So I did sentence mining, three-channel reading, intensive reading, and free flow, all with the same piece of content. That's multi-pass immersion. That's all I have for you today. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you found this useful. Are you interested in trying out this technique? Do you do it already? What are your favorite parts of the process? Is there another activity you love that I didn't mention? The comment section is always open, and I love hearing from you. And when you're down there, a quick thumbs up would be greatly appreciated. Thanks again for watching, and happy immersing. Hey, as you know, there's a lot of language learning advice out there, which can make it kind of overwhelming and difficult to actually get going on your own learning. If you feel like you're struggling to figure out language learning, you're not alone. It's an extremely complicated process with tons of different steps. If you're looking for a step-by-step guide to create the perfect language learning routine for you, then you have to check out our new course. We spent thousands of hours designing a simple and straightforward process that you can use to create your own personalized language routine that actually works. We understand that every learner is different and that you have to roll with the punches and adapt. Every day for 30 days, I walk you through everything you need to know to build an effective learning routine, no matter your circumstances. We give you the advice and resources you need to ensure your success, so you don't have to waste time looking for stuff to do and can focus on learning. And if any questions do come up, don't worry. We are always there to answer any questions and clear up confusion. And it's all backed by our 90-day, no questions asked, money-back guarantee. If, for whatever reason, something's not quite working for you, we insist you get every penny back. It's time for you to stop wishing that you could learn a second language. It's time to become the master of your language learning journey. Check out the link below to get instant access and start your journey today.